All right. We'll just continue trigonometric equations. Just doing some more questions from the mains material. Morning, the last question we've done was 35. So we'll continue from 37. Cos power 4x minus a plus 2 into cos square x minus a plus 3 equal to 0. This is somewhat like a quadratic equation in terms of cos square x when it will have a solution. Normally, I would have brought a one side, everything else another side, but let us at least split wherever a is there, wherever a is not there. So when I separate it, I get cos power 4x minus 2 cos square x and minus 3. Next, wherever a is there, that is minus a cos square x minus a. For this, when I factorize it, I'll get cos square x plus 1 into cos square x minus 3. And from these two, if I take minus a common, I'll get cos square x plus 1 equal to 0. Okay, so we'll take cos square x plus 1 common. We will get cos square x minus 3 minus a equal to 0. So cos this cannot be 0. Cos square x cannot be minus 1. So we'll not have any solution. Cos square x equal to minus 1 or cos square x is equal to 3 plus a. Or cos square x minus 3 equal to either. So here no solution. Here if you want a solution, a should be within the range of this. Cos square x minimum is 0 and maximum is 1. When I put 0, I'll get minus 3. When I put 1, I'll get minus 2. Okay. So a should belongs to, when I put 0, minus 3. When I put 1, minus 2. Almost same in other ways. You can send this one that side and write cos square x is equal to 3 plus a. And this is between 0 to 1. So 3 plus a also should be between 0 and 1 to have solution. That is same as minus 3 less than equal to a less than equal to minus 2. So as long as a is between closed interval minus 3 to minus 2, you'll have a solution. Otherwise, not. Is it okay, 37? Yes, sir. Okay. Yes, please.
Sir, you told that you will tell 29 questions.
Yeah. Even earlier in functions also, I said I'll send one solution. Let I'm going to erase. Anybody needs more time?
So 1 minute.
Okay. Okay, next 39. We have 8 power 1 plus mod cos x plus mod cos x whole square. So it's an infinite GP equal to 64, which can be written as 8 square. When I equate the powers, I'll get 1 plus mod cos x plus mod cos x whole square. So on up to infinity is 2. So I can use a GP formula for infinite one, a by 1 minus r. 1 by 1 minus mod cos x is equal to 2. So I'll get 1 minus mod cos x is equal to 1 by 2. And the mod cos x is 1 by 2. You can write cos x equal to plus or minus 1 by 2. Or anyway, they wanted solution only. But otherwise, this is same as cos square x is equal to 1 by 2 whole square, which is cos pi by 3 square. X is equal to n pi plus or minus pi by 3, where n belongs to z. This is a general solution. If you want only between minus pi to pi, then when you put 0, you'll get plus or minus pi by 3. When you put 1, you will get 4 pi by 3 and 2 pi by 3, but we'll take 2 pi by 3. When I take minus 1, I'll get minus 4 pi by 3 also, but minus 2 pi by 3 also will get. So among within minus pi to pi, there are only 4 solutions. Plus pi by 3, minus pi by 3, plus 2 pi by 3, minus 2 pi by 3. You do, without writing the general solution also, we can tell them. Even if you look at the figure, mod cos x graph is like this. So when I equate it to 1 by 2, I'll get 4 solutions between minus pi to pi. After 39, even 41 also I want to discuss along with the 29 later. We'll go to 43 and then rest of them. Okay, complicate 39. Okay. All of you, please put on your videos. Okay, I'm skipping 41 for the time being. 43. Mod cos x is equal to cos x minus 2 sin x. Okay, because mod is there, we have to take two cases. Cos x greater than or equal to 0. Cos x less than 0. Of course, equal to we can take anywhere. And cos x is positive, we can remove the mod symbol. It will be cos x is equal to cos x minus 2 sin x. Cos x will cancel. I'll get sin x equal to 0. Normally, when I take sin x equal to 0, I will get 0, pi, 2 pi. All multiples of pi. But cos x should be positive. We should not forget that. Normally, when sin x is 0, cos x is plus 1 or minus 1. But because cos x is positive, it should be plus 1 only. I don't need to write it, but I still want to write sin x equal to 0 and cos x equal to 1, but not cos x equal to minus 1. It may not be so important. Okay, sin x should be 0, cos x should be positive. If you look at the figure, sin x is 0 here and here. 0, pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, 4 pi, so on. In that, cos is negative at all these places. So we don't want to take, we want to take only this, which is actually multiples of 2 pi. So we'll get x is equal to 2n pi and not n pi. Normally, sin x equal to 0 would have been that. And cos x is negative, mod cos x, I can write minus cos x, which is equal to cos x minus 2 sin x. You can bring 2 sin x here, this to the other side, you will get 2 sin x is equal to 2 cos x. That is tan x equal to 1. Tan x equal to 1, we will get x is equal to n pi plus pi by 4. But again, wait, we should not complete this because not only tan x should be 1, cos x should be negative. Okay, so tan x 1 and cos x negative is which quadrant? Tan positive and cos negative.
Third quadrant.
Okay, so normally first quadrant also will get a solution 5 by 4. Third quadrant also will get a solution. But we should only take the third one and we should not take the first quadrant. So it is not n pi plus pi by 4 now. Okay, it is only third quadrant. How should we write? One answer will be 5 pi by 4. Rest of the answer will be 2n pi plus 5 pi by 4 because next first quadrant only again will get. Next third quadrant, sorry. So 5 pi by 4. 2 pi plus 5 pi by 4 and 4 pi plus 5 pi by 4, so on, which can be written as 2n pi plus 5 pi by 4. I don't know what the answer is given. I just wrote this. Yeah, 43, they gave D, which is this one. Option A is given, but that's not correct because for odd numbers it is not correct. Option B is also not correct. Here somebody would have written answer as n pi plus 5. So A and B, there is a chances of somebody putting the answer because they may get x equal to n pi here, but because of this it's not n pi. Here they may get x equal to n pi plus 5 by 4, but because of this it's not okay. I'm not saying option D is there. This and this both are there. Yeah. This or this n belongs to Z. Instead of giving 5 pi by 4, they give 2n pi plus pi plus pi by 4. You can write 2n pi plus pi plus pi by 4, and that is written as 2n plus 1 into pi plus pi by 4. Okay. So many questions you have to go by routine formulas. But here, but understand cos x is positive. So within the formula, some part of it has to be removed. Here cos x is negative, so within the routine formula, some part of it has to be removed. Is it okay? 43?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, anybody any doubt or anybody needs more time?
Sir. Sir.
Okay. Somebody with the name Doberman, who is that? Are they still there?
Just now gone, sir.
Okay, all right. Maybe just some dog came in and went. Yes, Saket, you're asking some doubt.
I was going to complain that some guy is texting continuously, Doberman.
Ach, okay. Okay, this is done. 45. This 45 and later on in numerical questions, the sixth question, and there are one or two other questions may not be here. In JE mains, at least in the recent times, I gave questions and even earlier also. Sometimes we may not be able to solve an equation, but we can tell it doesn't have any solution. How will you tell that? You find LHS range and RHS range. That is, somehow you are able to tell LHS is always less than or equal to 3. And you are able to tell RHS is always greater than or equal to 5. Can LHS be equal to RHS? Is it possible?
No, sir.
Yeah. And let us say this is also greater than or equal to 3. This is less than or equal to 3, that is greater than or equal to 3. Then equal to is possible.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. 3. Yeah, LHS must be 3 and RHS must be 3, and they should attain at the same X value. They cannot attain at different X value. Okay. So some questions are based on extreme values. So this question is of that type where we have 2 cos square x by 2 sine square x equal to x square plus 1 by x square. LHS is less than or equal to 2 and RHS is greater than or equal to 2. How is RHS greater than or equal to 2? You can use AMJ inequality. I think all of you know AMJ inequality, that a plus b by 2 is greater than or equal to root ab. Based on that, x square plus 1 by x square by 2 is greater than or equal to square root of x square into 1 by x square. You can send 2 here. Let x square plus 1 by x square is greater than or equal to 2. Without all that, if somebody can make perfect square, you can also write x square plus 1 by x square as x minus 1 by x whole square plus 2. Something whole square plus 2 is greater than or equal to 2 because this minimum is 0. Whatever it is, RHS is greater than or equal to 2. Coming to LHS, sine square x is always between 0 to 1. Maximum value is 1. Cos square x by 2 is also between 0 to 1. So cos square x by 2 is less than or equal to 1. And sine square x is less than or equal to 1 into 2 is there. So LHS is less than or equal to 2. Actually, it is not even less than or equal to 2. It is only less than 2. Anybody want to tell me why I did not write equal to 2? Only I wrote less than 2.
For same x values, it is not possible, sir.
Yes.
Yeah. The only way this product can be attain 1 is when both are 1. If anything is less than 1, the product will be less than 1. So both are 1 simultaneously not happens, because when this is 0, this... When this is 0, sine will be 1. Am I right? Cos x by 2 went. After some time, if my class ends, you can use the same link and rejoin again. Okay? Because I'm using the free version. Cos square x by 2, when it will be 1, when x by 2 is a multiple of 2 pi and x is a multiple of 4 pi. X by 2 is a multiple. X can be any multiple of 2 pi, okay? Because it will get pi. Yeah. So basically x should x by 2 should be n pi and x should be 2 n pi. But whenever x is 2 n pi, sin square x will be 0. Okay. Or another way of saying is sin x is 2 sin x by 2 cos x by 2. Whenever cos x by 2 is 1, sin x by 2 will be 0, it will be 0. Okay. So when this is 1, this is 0. And similarly, when this is 1, this will not be 1 because your x will be pi by 2, 3 pi by 2. Then x by 2 will be pi by 4, 3 pi by 4. So they don't happen simultaneously. So LHS is less than 2, RHS is greater than or equal to 2. There's no chance that they can be equal. So LHS is always less than RHS. LHS equal to RHS, okay, has no solution. Doesn't have solution. Even if somebody writes equal to 2 here, then they have to understand LHS and RHS must be equal to 2 simultaneously. And RHS is 2 only when x is 1 or minus 1. And when you substitute that, LHS will not be 2. Okay, like that also you can tell. LHS equal to RHS equal to 2 is not possible also. Not necessary because I already removed equality. Okay. So there will be quite a few questions of this type. Here we gave a little less, maybe in advance material we'll find some more. I can even make up some questions where equality can happen. Let us say x square minus 2 root 3x. Plus 4. That is greater than or equal to 1. So I have to write something less than or equal to, yeah. Sin pi x by 2 root 3. Let us say, I'm just creating a question. Look at this. Normally, a trigonometric expression and algebraic expression we cannot solve. We know how to solve algebraic expressions only. But even if I give a simple question, 3x plus 5 is equal to 2 power 7x plus 3. Can you solve this equation? No, because we cannot factorize anything. It is 2 power and this, okay? Sometimes one or two numbers we may be able to guess, but it's not possible to solve it. Very rare cases we'll be able to guess x. In the same way, whenever you have algebraic versus trigonometry, algebraic versus logarithmic, algebraic versus exponential, we will not be able to solve it. But this is again based on extreme values. LHS is less than or equal to 1. Sine of something is less than or equal to 1. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
And RHS, if you make perfect square, you will get x minus root 3 whole square plus 1. Because 4 you can write 3 plus
1. Greater than equals 1.
Yeah. So LHS is less than or equal to 1. RHS is greater than or equal to 1. The only chance they can be equal is both must be 1. And both equal to 1, is it possible?
Yes, sir.
Possible. When RHS attain 1 at x equal to root 3.
X equal to root 3.
If I put that root 3, LHS is also becoming 1. So x equal to root 3 is the only solution. If I change, yes, the question, sir, slightly, where I remove this root 3, if I write root 5 or don't write anything, then where this attains 1 and this attains 1 doesn't match, then no solution. Right? If you want to look at graphically, I'll give you an idea about this question. Let us say my sine curve is somewhat like this. Okay. One time the parabola is exactly touching the sine curve at this point. That is greater than or equal to 1. This is less than or equal to 1. And here they can be equal. Same parabola if I move a little bit towards left. Like this. Okay. Yes, this is less than or equal to 1. This is greater than or equal to 1. But both cannot be equal to 1 at same x value, so there is no solution. So when I change that root 3 to root 5, what happened with the slightly is, earlier they were touching at the same point, but now they slightly moved horizontally, where they don't happen simultaneously. Okay, so there will be questions where you will not be able to solve it directly. You have to find a range of LHS and RHS. Okay, LHS and RHS finding range, there are only two uses. Either to tell no solution in the case like this, or there is unique or something like that. Let us say you get LHS less than or equal to 7 and RHS is greater than or equal to 2. Then what to do? Then we'll not be able to conclude. They may have a solution. Both may be equal to 3 or 4 or 4.2 or 6 or 6.8, something like that. Okay. Because this is less than 7, there are more than 2. There are a lot of cases or choices where they may be equal. Okay. So no solution or a particular solution where they're equal only, we can tell with this method. When you get a lot of range, we'll not be able to tell. Is it okay, 45?
Sir, what is the last word?
I am saying LHS equal to RHS equal to 2 is not possible.
Sir, I did not understand. Once can you explain?
What do you not understood? Fully. Okay. Difficult to solve a trigonometric and algebraic expression. Okay. So what we have done, we found RHS range. We understood RHS value is always 2 or more than that. And LHS value is always 2 or less than that. And it is not even 2. So LHS is less than 2 and RHS is greater than or equal to 2. A number less than 2 and a number more than 2, can they be equal?
No, sir.
No, that's a no solution. That's it.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Do you like some interior designing and that kind of thing or what?
No, sir.
Not. Okay. All right, 47. Once again, if this meeting ends, don't think class is over. You have to rejoin with the same link. A1 plus A2 sin x plus A3 cos x plus A4 sin 2x plus A5 cos 2x equal to 0 for all x belongs to R. Whenever an equation like this, if it is true for all x belongs to R, we call that as identity. For example, our first chapter, trigonometric ratios and identities. That is because sine square x plus cos square x is equal to 1 for all x values, not for some x values. Similarly, secant square x minus tan square x equal to 1 is for all x values. So whatever x you take, 0 degrees, 10 degrees, 9 degrees, 20 degrees, it should be true. Okay. Some that kind of things are called identities. We are solving trigonometric equations where they are not identities because we are getting only one or two x values which are satisfying, one or two, or it may be infinite but not every real number. Okay. Okay, I'll wait for 2 minutes for others to join. Just a minute, I have a message for others.
Sir, what is five tuples, sir?
I'll tell you. Okay, five tuple basically means you have an ordered pair. If two things are there, it's called ordered pair. When three things are there, it's called ordered triad in a bracket, right? If you have five things, it's called five tuple.
Okay. Yes,
multiple. Okay, in that one on tuple is there. Huh? Okay, basically that. Yes, please.
Can you explain what you wrote in the board?
No, I not started. I was waiting for others to join. Okay.
Okay.
I just wrote these things, but I have not explained. I am going to explain about the difference between identity and an equation. An equation will have some solutions, maybe x value or y value or x and y pairs. If you substitute only those particular values, it will be 0 or LHS equal to RHS. At any particular other values, LHS will not be equal to RHS. Identity means whatever real number you keep. Okay. LHS and RHS should be equal. Okay, now let us look at this question. Let us look at this where people can answer more easily. I am looking for a real number A, real number B, real number C, such that whatever X you take, this will come zero. Whether you put 10 degrees, 20 degrees, 10 radians, 100 radians, it should be zero. Anybody want to tell some
A,
B, C?
Equal to B, equal to C, zero. All are zero.
No, you are wrong. I'm talking about this equation. All are zero is one answer, correct? Yes, you are right. But other than 0, 0, 0, is there any other option? Is it that A, B, C must be zero? Sorry, I have to correct myself. You told correct that A equal to 0, B equal to 0, C equal to 0, correct. Nothing wrong. Are there any other sets of A, B, C values which can satisfy this?
C minus C equals to A plus B by 2.
What?
Minus C equals to A plus B by 2.
Are you sure about it? You are asking me to write C as minus A plus B by 2. Do you think it is 0 for all X values?
No, sir. For some.
But I want for all X belongs to R.
Sir, C is minus of A sin square plus B cos square.
C plus
C should be a number. C should not depend on X. It should be independent of X, man.
Equal to B, equal to minus.
Yeah, somebody wrote in the chart, A equal to B equal to minus C. Okay? If I take A and B are equal and take C as, for example, I'll take B also as A, C as minus A. A sin square X plus A cos square X minus A equal to 0. Is it true for some x values or is it true for all x values?
All x values.
For all x values.
All x values, sir.
Yeah. So when you can make A and sin these two same and this of opposite sign of that, then they don't need to be zero. You can take 7 here, 7 here, minus 7. You can take 100 here, 100 here, minus 100. You can take root 3 minus root 3. Okay. Now, apart from telling like that, is there any way to prove it? Somebody may ask. Yeah, I can prove it. Put x equal to 0 degrees. What will come? B plus c equal to 0. Put x equal to 90 degrees. What will come? A plus c equal to 0. Root c is equal to minus a equal to minus b. One may say, why you kept only 0 and 90? No, you keep other things. You keep 30 degrees, 45 degrees, 60 degrees. You'll get many equations. You try to solve them. Again, you'll get this relation only. Let us say I'll put 45 degrees. What I'll get? A by 2 plus B by 2 plus C equal to 0. Let us say I'll put 30 degrees. What I'll get? A by 4 plus 3B by 4 plus C equal to 0. You try to solve these two, I'm sure you'll get this only. Okay. When you subtract these two, what will come? I'll get A by 4 minus B by 4 equal to 0. I'll get A equal to B. Put that A equal to B back, you'll get C equal to minus. Again, same thing. Okay. So, one way to check is keep on different x values. You'll get so many equations. You have only three unknowns. You'll try to solve. You'll get either ABC values or a relation between them. Okay. This one is like that. Let us say this one. Can somebody tell me an example of ABC or what should be relation between ABC so that whatever X you take, it should be 0 always. One obvious answer is A0, B0, C0. If I write, even in the previous case, if I take 0
into A equals to minus 2, B equals
to. Just a minute. You take 0 into sin square X plus 0 into cos square X plus 0 equal to 0. This statement is true for some X values, for all X values.
For all x values.
For all x values. Okay, so for this 0, 0, 0 is also correct, but some other options are also there. And the answer that we wrote includes 0, 0, 0 because we wrote c equal to minus a equal to minus b. Yeah, now somebody is saying about this. What is that?
Minus 2a equals to b equals to c.
Minus 2a equal to b equal to c. Okay. You want me to write B as minus 2A, C as minus 2A. Are you sure about it?
Sir, minus 2A equal to B equal to C minus A.
You want to tell C minus A. So basically you want to tell B should be minus 2A and you want to tell C is minus A. Am I right?
So, C
as
C minus A.
That only. So, that minus A, if you bring this side, you'll get C equal to minus A, no? Yeah. So, yeah, because cos 2x has a formula, 2 cos square x minus 1. You can exploit that and you can tell. Or if somebody writes minus 2A here and minus A here, you can take A common. You'll see cos 2x minus 2 cos square x. I think C should be plus A, right? Should be plus A. So that you will get plus 1. And cos 2x formula is 2 cos square x minus 1, they'll cancel. Yeah. So then, okay, so it is not necessary that all coefficients need to be 0. They can be, you can have 8 here, minus 16 here, 8 here, and so many other ways. Again, one way to identify is take different x values, you'll get some equations. Okay. But you don't need, you can, you know this formula for this. Okay, even in the previous one, I should have written this as 1 minus sin square x. When I written this as 1 minus sin square x, I would have got a minus b into sin square x plus b plus c equal to 0. Something into sin square x plus some constant should be 0 for all x values means this itself should be 0, this itself should be 0. Okay, even that if you want to prove it, put x equal to 0, you'll get this equal to 0. Oh, and once that is gone, if you want this into this to be 0, the only chance is this must be 0. Like that, we will get. Same thing here. Somebody can write this as 2 cos square x minus 1. When you open it up, you will get 2a plus b into cos square x plus c minus a. Some number into cos square x plus some number, if you want it to be 0 for all x values, this itself should be 0. This itself should be 0. If you want, you can take x equal to 0 degrees, 90 degrees, you will get to understand. Right? Okay. So, in the two middle ones, the equations, if you want them to be true for all x values, it is not necessary that a, b, c all must be zero. I'm able to find some other relation, mainly because there is a identity formula between these two, Whereas the first one is not like that. A cos x plus b sin x, a sin x plus b cos x plus c, if you want to be zero for all x values, the only way is a must be zero, b must be zero, c must be zero. That is because there is no formula relating to sin x and cos x without squares, of course, directly. If you want to say how you are saying this, you take different values. Okay, you put x equal to 0 degrees, what will come? B plus c equal to 0. You put x is equal to 90 degrees, you will get a plus c equal to 0. Okay, that means now I can substitute a as minus c, b also as minus c. When I substitute minus c and take common that minus c, I will be getting sin x plus cos x minus 1 equal to 0. Now you substitute any other x value, this will not be 0, but this will be 0, so you'll get c equal to 0. Or don't even take this, take some 30 degrees or something, you'll get an equation. In that substitute, these results will end up with C0. On C0, B0, A0. Without that, theoretically, I can say that there is no formula relating to these two in a linear way. Okay? Whereas there is a formula connecting these two, there's a formula connecting these two. Coming to this last example, here also ABC must be zero because there is no formula connecting sin 3x and sin x without any squares and cubes. There is a formula where sin 3x is 3 sin x minus 4 sin cube x. That question also I can ask. If I can ask another question, for example, if somebody say, I say A sin 3x plus B sin x plus C sin cube x equal to 0 for all x belongs to R, then it is not necessary that A must be 0, B must be 0, C must be 0. No, because there is a formula connecting these things. Okay, what is that? I can even tell, I use formula 3 sin x, so I want b to be minus b, so that will get cancelled. When I use minus 4 sin cube x, so c should be plus 4a. When b is minus 3a, c is plus 4a, doesn't matter what is a, this whole thing will be always 0. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Basically, this is some in vectors I'll discuss in detail, it is called linear dependence and independence. If I have some quantities involved, okay, if you are able to find this in terms of these two, we say they are linearly dependent. And if you are not able to write this in terms of these two, they say linearly independent. Okay, but don't worry about all those terms. But here, these are like dependent. One can be expressed in terms of other. These are like independent because it is not this, another example where they cannot be expressed. Why I'm telling all that? Directly, there's no relation between sin x, cos x, sin 2x, and cos 2x. So they're actually, there's no interrelation. So I should say a1, a2, a3, a4, a5, all should be 0. Okay. Just let me tell one thing. I explain all these things. But as I told you before, in mains material, trigonometric equations, the first 20 to 25 questions are okay, where based on the routine formula that we discussed. Others are all miscellaneous questions where each question may need some other concept. Some is by the graph, some is by the extreme values, some is about this kind of interrelation and all that. Okay. So I told you already, don't do mains material first in this chapter, unless you've done first 20 questions in that even numbers. IP, you do it, go through solved examples, start doing IP exercise. You will find more comfortable. That also few doubts may be there, but you'll find more comfortable. You'll be confident. And then you can try these questions.
Okay,
so method one, without much explanation, understanding the interrelation between the different quantities, I can straight away say, if you want this to be true for all x values, a1 equal to a2 equal to a3 equal to a4 equal to a5, all must be 0. If somebody is not fully agreeable to that directly, or not confident to write that, then keep on substituting different x values, get many equations and try to solve. I don't know, is it going to be easy or difficult? Let me see. If I put x equal to 0, I'll get a1 plus a3 plus a5 is 0. Because sine part is 0. When I put x is equal to pi, I'll get a1 minus a3 plus a5 equal to 0. X equal to pi also still sine is 0. I can put any values, just I'm trying to put different things, that's all. If I put x is equal to pi by 2, I cannot make cos x and cos 2x simultaneously 0. It's not possible. And whenever sin x is 0, sin 2x will be 0. Of course, whenever sin 2x is 0, sin x minimum will not be 0. When I put x equal to pi by 2, I'll get a1 plus a2. This will be 0. This will be 0. And then cos pi is minus a5 equal to 0. Anyway, to carefully choose, but what I'll be doing, I'll be getting different equations, and somehow I'll add 2-3 equations, I'll be getting each one as 0. For example, by adding these two, I'll get a1 plus a5 is 0. By subtracting these two, I'll get a3 equal to 0. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now if I put any one of them here, what is that? A5, I can write this as minus A1. So if I write A5 as minus A1 from this, I'll get 2A1 plus A2 is 0. Or I can substitute this result and change the equation itself right in the beginning and then make it a little more easier. Let me do one thing. These results, I'll use it back now. It will become A1 plus A2 sine x. A3 is not there now. A4 is sine 2x. And A5, I can add minus A1. Minus A1 cos 2x equal to 0. Now, this and this together, I can combine and write 2 sine square x. Yeah, then that makes it easier. A2 sine x, A4 sine 2x. This and this together is A1 into 2 sine square x. That should be 0. I can take this also. I have 2 sine x cos x formula for sine 2x. So I can take sine x common. Then I will get 2a1 sine x plus a2. This is 2 sine x cos x. After taking sine x common, 2a4 cos x equal to 0. If you want this to be true for all x values, 30 degrees, 40 degrees, 50 degrees, and all that, then I think this should be 0 because this will not be 0 every time. So I can say from this that 2a1 sine x plus a2 plus 2a4 cos x should be 0 for all x belongs to R. From this again, I can put some 30 degrees, 0 degrees, 90 degrees. I think I'll get some other result. I'll be able to prove a1, a2, a4 all are 0. Earlier also, we already done this question. A sine x plus b cos x plus c equal to 0. Did I not prove that abc must be 0? I proved
yes,
it.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So, like that also, you can. So it may be a little lengthy because we have taken 5 variables. If they have given 3 or something, would have done more easily, but still nothing wrong here.
Sir, so slowly we are reducing the number of unknown variables.
Yes, exactly, exactly. Even if they give 100 variables, if you are confidently know that there is no interrelation between them, you can say. But yes, for that, some maturity of the function. Okay, so I can straight away say that this is 0. Otherwise, I have to put some values and then try to solve this. Okay, right now I'm not going to go into detail. I'm going to simply write a1 equal to a2 equal to a4 equal to 0, since I proved earlier. And if a1 is 0, a5 is also 0. That was already eliminated. So basically, we got that all must be 0. That is the only thing. So you can see this is not connected to any one of the theory of the mainly related to this chapter. In the beginning, we discussed some theory. It's not about that. Next, we'll discuss numerical questions in that odd numbers. Anybody any doubt regarding 47?
No, sir.
Sir?
Yes, please.
So meaning there is only one 5 tuple where whole expression is 0.
Yes. The set of A1, A2, A3, A4, A5 values, they are calling it as 5 tuple. How many such sets of answers? There is only one set, which is all zeros, right?
No, but actually, we have proved mathematically that there are no more possible 5 tuples, right?
We proved it now already. We thoroughly proved it here that all of them must be 0, mathematically only. Right now, so method 1 is because of the general understanding I wrote, because I already discussed quite a few examples, but method 2 I proved thoroughly.
Yes, sir, I understand.
And one more theoretical thing I can tell, other than 0, 0, 0, 0, if there is another solution, let us say, then it actually means infinite solution. Let us say somehow A1 is 7, this is minus 9, this is 4, this is 3, this is 2, somehow let us say is okay. Then 70, minus 90, 40, 30, 20 also okay. I can multiply 10 also, no? I can multiply 100,000, okay? So either it will have one multiple or infinite multiples, nothing in between.
Yes. So technically, if we can prove that like all of the identities, they do not have any correlation, like they are not related to each other, we can say that there is only one solution.
Yes, that is all coefficients are 0.
Sir?
Yes, please.
In this type of questions, answers will be 1 or infinite, you know, sir?
Yes, that's what I am saying. Either 1 or infinite, infinite cannot be answered, so answer is 1. Infinite is also there, option D is there. Whereas earlier I wrote some questions, there where many cases are there, there will be infinite. If somebody asks, A sin square x plus B cos square x plus C equal to 0. How many triads are there? How many sets of ABC values are there satisfying this? That will be infinite, right?
Yes, sir.
And wait, it's a very specific question. It is not that you will find this kind of question, so many questions or something like that. Okay, so numericals, first question, cot theta minus tan theta is equal to secant theta. They wanted only between 0 to 2 pi. And write cos theta by sin theta minus sin theta by cos theta is equal to 1 by cos theta. This is cos square minus sin square, cos square theta minus sin square theta by sin theta cos theta equal to 1 by cos theta. Of course, one thing we should know, at the end, whatever solution we get, cot theta and tan theta should be defined. If they are not defined, then it is meaningless. Okay? Why I am saying that? I can cancel, for example, cos theta and send sin theta, that's right. Cos square theta minus sin square theta equal to sin theta. I may get a solution where cos theta may be 0. Okay. But if cos theta is 0, it is not even defined. This is not even defined, right? And earlier I said don't cancel anything. You bring one side and take common. Okay. But here I can cancel safely because even if I take common, I'll get 1 by cos theta only common. And that can't be 0. Okay. I will write that also, just for the sake of writing. Maybe I can do cross multiplication first. Cos theta
is also cos theta.
That is cross multiplication. I'll get cos theta into cos square theta minus sin square theta equal to sin theta cos theta. And I should not forget, these two are not same. Because in this I may get sin theta equal to 0 as one solution or cos theta equal to 0 as one solution, but that's not be defined. I should also write and sin theta not equal to 0, cos theta not equal to 0. Now I can take cos theta common, or I can even cancel because it is not 0, so I can safely cancel now. Earlier I should I take common and that equal to 0 solution will miss, but now not a problem. So this is sine, this is sine, better to write this also in terms of sine. So 1 minus sine square theta minus sine square theta equal to sine theta. Let's send everything to the other side. 2 sine square theta plus sine theta minus 1 equal to 0. Sine theta equal to minus 1 is the obvious solution. So sine theta plus 1 into 2 sine theta minus 1 equal to 0. So we are getting sine theta equal to minus 1 or sine theta equal to 1 by 2. It is very important to recognize that this we should not take. Because whenever sine theta is minus 1, cos theta is 0 and cos theta should not be 0. Okay. That is where you can, your answer can go wrong in the number of solutions.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So here we don't have any solution. No solution since cos theta should not be 0. No solution since cos theta should not be 0. This is okay. When sin theta is 1 by 2, neither sin is 0 nor cos is 0. What are solutions will get? Between 0 to 2 pi. Why only 1 by 2, 1 by 5, anything, sine will have only two solutions in one interval. Okay, so we'll have two solutions. So one can easily mistake the answer to be 3 if they don't recognize that part. So this implies theta is equal to 30 degrees and 150. That's what is between 0 to 2 pi.